Very good morning. Welcome to Financial Freedom Show. I'm C.S. Sudhir. Mr. Dhirendra has posted a question on the Financial Freedom app. He says, is it good to avail consumer durables loan while purchasing mobile phone, furniture and stuff for home? Is that really good? In fact, if you ask me this question, I would definitely say, no, don't do that mistake. I'll tell you why. Many people think, okay, it's a zero interest loan, zero cost EMI. What does it really mean? Is it really, you know, truly a zero cost EMI or loan? No, there won't be. There won't be anything called that. See, I'll tell you what happens. Normally what happens between these distributors or showrooms are the e-commerce players and the banks, there will be an agreement arrangement. So what do they do now? They would say, if you fund my customers to purchase these things, we will give you the commission. So then what happens? Banks will waive off the interest component and they recover that interest component from these distributors or showrooms. So and by doing that, what happens? The showroom's business will go up. In turn, you're paying for it, right? So I don't recommend you do that. Normally, all those people who say zero cost EMI, all those people, they would have increased the price to that extent. I don't suggest you do that. Now, coming back to what happens, I'll tell you. So when you're purchasing furniture or electronic goods on this zero interest or zero, you know, no cost EMI or even simple EMI format, you're basically purchasing what you can't really afford. See, these are the basic stuffs you need for your house, right? If you can't afford it, I mean, you don't have enough money to buy this, it means you're not saved for it or you're not really eligible for it. So hold on, I mean, wait for some more time. These are not necessities. These are not even needs. It's okay, even if you don't have it today, it's okay, you can buy it later. I've seen people purchasing sofa, purchasing costly electronic goods on EMI, and they work for months and years to pay it back. And many a times I've seen these people missing their EMIs, and in turn, they end up with paying a huge penalty on check bounce charges, huge penalty on late payment, extra interest and all that. On top of it, they spoil their credit score. Their credit history gets spoiled. And then what happens? You won't get any loan later. Don't make that mistake. And again, I'm repeating, those so-called zero interest loans are not truly zero interest loans. They will have back-end charges. Believe me, they will have it. You should not get trapped by these people. Same time, they may say it's a zero interest loan, but they will have processing fee. They say that, okay, it's one-time processing fee of 800 rupee on a loan of 10,000 rupee. What percentage are you paying? Literally 8% upfront you're paying, right? So what does it mean? It means though they don't charge you interest, they're charging you in the name of processing fee. So don't get fooled by these things. At the same time, some of these people would say, I'm going to give you pre-approved loan. What does it mean? It means they are basically checking your credit score and information, and they say, I have got a pre-approved loan to buy this stuff from this, you know, e-commerce portal or from this shop. And you believe them and you take it. See, the pre-approved loan they're giving you based on your income, not based on your dreams and aspirations. They're basically diverting your funds from your dreams, your goals, your aspirations to some other unwanted luxuries. What happens later? You will not really have money to fund your dreams and aspirations later, which means, think about it, I'm saving X amount of money currently for my son's education, so daughter's education. But suddenly, you get to see an advertisement by some e-commerce portal or some shop claiming that they're going to give you pre-approved loan to buy some electronic course. You divert these funds which you've kept aside for son's education to this. This is why we have designed various courses on personal finance and Financial Freedom app to help you learn financial discipline. Because if you don't develop, if you don't learn financial discipline, believe me, your dream of becoming rich will never happen. So I want you to watch these courses on personal finance on Financial Freedom app. Not just that, we have about 55 courses on personal finance, career, business, farming on Financial Freedom app. Please watch all these courses. Also, if you have any questions related to these subjects, related to these topics, please post your questions on the Financial Freedom app. I will answer your questions in my next episode. Thanks for watching. Be wise, get rich.